Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're here with Kimberly Howard. She is the Trust Manager for the Oregon Cultural Trust, and Mr. David Hattner, who is the Conductor and Musical Director for the Portland Youth Philharmonic. And in the next segment, we'll actually hear a performance from a couple members of the Philharmonic. I wanted to ask you something. Right about now, if you listen really intently, you can hear someone saying, well, if the art's so popular and so representative of my state and culture, why can't it support itself? Kimberly?
Well, this is something actually we hear a lot, and I think the important thing to realize is that arts and culture is a business just like anything else. The cultural nonprofits that we support have a certain, and I make a little pie gram, amount of money that they get from various sources. And in general, about 60%, and that's on the high end, is from earned revenue, and that's, you know, ticket sales or tuition. And everything else needs to come from donations. That's how nonprofits work. So they come from individual contributions, they come from corporate contributions, they come from grants, from foundations, from places like the Oregon Cultural Trust, the Oregon Arts Commission, from the Regional Arts and Culture Council. Those are the public funders. And then you have the private funders, like the Miller Foundation or the Collins Foundation. And that makes up the pie. And there is only so much money out there in that pie, which is one of the reasons why the Cultural Trust was created, to supplement some of the money that was needed in order to make those organizations run.
David, you've talked a lot about the importance of art and music education, especially in schools. In your opinion, in your personal opinion, do Portland schools do enough in terms of music education? And if not, why is it important that they do more?
It's a really difficult question because the budgetary restrictions right now are so severe, it's hard to see a place for music education. But when the Portland Junior Symphony was founded in 1924, there were so many things that were unexpected that came out of this high-level music training that they did. They discovered that the members of the orchestra got better grades than their peers. They discovered that they stayed out of trouble and they went to college in greater numbers. And this happened for so many generations that it's discovered that it's not a coincidence. So when scientists study these things, they discover what musicians have known for years, that music and the performance of it, especially on an instrument, engages the entire brain in a way that is rarely completed by any other activity. All you have to do is think about what playing music involves. First of all, you have to read the notes on the page. That's a visual stimulation. Then you have to process that through motor connections, and you have to listen to yourself. So that's the audio portion of the brain. And then there's that hard to explain emotional connection that all human beings have to music. So all these things are integrated, and when you take a three-year-old and put them into that situation, imagine how much more stimulating that is than any other activity that you can have. So when they say that there's just no place for music in schools anymore, I understand why they say it, but it makes me very sad because there's very few things that a school can do that can actually expand a student's intellectual capacity in the first place. And I think music is one of those very few things.
If you want to find out more about the Oregon Cultural Trust, you can go to the address you see on your screen. When we come back, we'll see a performance by two of the students from the Portland Youth Philharmonic. That is when Outlook Portland continues right after this on Northwest 32. Stay right there.